Hello, Pia Gang. Today we're going to do a before work and after work routine. I hope you guys like it. So this is how I live for work. Sometimes she follows me, especially when she's nicked. And this is us bargaining. Tamu, tamu, and me telling her I'm going to bring her tamu. So, you know, in her mind, she knows it's crisps, biscuits, but takuja na ngwashi, na ndoma. And she'll still like it. But I don't always blackmail her. Sometimes I bring her those tamus. And sometimes I literally run. Because when she sees me one other time, it's going to be a cry battle. So I better run. So I leave for work. And I leave her at home to grow. And then now I can do some checkups during the day. Maybe one or two depending on why I'm calling. I would advise moms who leave their kids with nannies. So it's important to always call your nanny or the person you left the kid with. And always find out, you know, has she slept well? Is she okay? It's important, but you don't have to nag. Even once sometimes is enough. Because you have to trust another human being to take care of your baby. It's hard, but you have to trust. And it's around 5:30 and I'm back home. I can't wait to be at home. I can't wait to sit on that couch and stretch my legs and take a shower. I just can't wait. Sometimes I'm exhausted. And I know she won't let me. The moment I open up this door, she is not going to let me. Because she misses me too, and I've been missing her. And it's going to be bond time. But do you know, guys, what bond time is? My cups and her milk. That is what she wants, first and foremost. Before I can even rest, that is what she wants. So at times I won't be able to take a shower, I won't be able to do anything else until I do breastfeed her. So what I do, I take warm water and a clean cotton wool, dab it in the warm water, and you know, just wipe out her cups. Oh, sorry, my cups, her milk. So I wipe out the cups and she's good to go. And this is bonding time. I look at her. I look at her hair, I scrutinize her small facial features, I look at her toes. I mean, this is the best time to, you know, check up on her physical representation and see, you know, check up on anything. You can check up for marks or anything. And I have a really good nanny. I remember the first day, I think they were left together and she was trying to follow her outside, so she fell and she hurt her lip. And before I could do anything, the nanny was there and she told me what happened. And I think that's a good nanny. You might be unfortunate and get someone who doesn't really tell you how the kid behaved during the day or how they related. So this time you can, for moms out there, or even for dads, you can as well check up on her during this time. And it's always good if your nanny, my nanny is a day nanny, so she goes home when I come back from work. And with that, I think it's always good to make a point to see her. You can arrange a time in which you see her before she goes, so that she can, you know, she's leaving the baby to you, so she has to tell you how the baby has been performing. You know, it's like a day night shift and your workmates. And now that she's watching her cartoon, and I think this is Sophia the First with some song, some Genie Rules song, if I'm not wrong. I've seen this kind of song before. I think it's Genie Rules. Yeah, so when she's watching her cartoon and everything, I can do other things. Right now, I can even take a shower. I can even warm her food. I can even wipe my shoes. I can do a lot of things when she's watching the TV because she gives me the time to, and she loves her shoes. And she loves those songs. But one thing though, people, I think I don't know. Maybe you guys can advise me for people who know anything, for people who know anything about this matter. Kids love to watch their shows when they're so close to the television, and I find that really, I'm not okay with that because of eyesight. So I don't know, are there like anti-glares you can buy, or are there like kids anti-glare that, you know, like the proportion of the anti-glare is directly proportional to the age of the, you know. Okay, I'm saying, are there anti-glares one can buy to like enable, even if the kid moves close to the television, you don't have to worry so much? Because mine, as much as I put like, you know, some cushions like a meter or 2 meters away from the television, she is still going to insist to watch. So, and I have to let her, because right now I'm doing something else now and I can't stay here. We're going to argue, and I always comfort myself because it's a short kind of show, and I'll be here to now feed her in the next few minutes. She can as well do it. But I'm not okay with it. I don't have to be okay with everything she's doing. So she's watching her shows and she's finished and we've taken supper. Now she can take a bath. And the days, well, it's been cold. I don't know if it's cold out there, you people, but it's been cold in Kirinyaga County. The Pia gang in Kirinyaga can attest to this. It's been really cold. And I don't know if everyone has been showering the baby every single day. Mine has been skipping days. So what I've been doing, I've been like, sometimes I've been wiping her the entire body. Wiping. So today is one of these days. I will have to wipe her because today it's cold. I don't know if you guys saw how I layered when I went to work. There was a lot of layering going on. And I can imagine this kind of work. I know some people are gonna say, you know, put up a heater, you know, and it's okay, heater is okay, I can do that, but now I'll have to wipe her. So I'm wiping her 1 minute and then I'll be done. But that is just how the routine is, and that is how we go on about our day. So I hope you guys really like these kinds of video, and tune in to subscribe for more. Bye.